Hello, I'm Marta De Felice, a postdoc in Dr. Steven Averett Laboratory at Western University. My project focuses on how the hippocampal formation is affected by adolescent TSE exposure. It is well known that cannabis use during adolescence increases risk for cognitive impairment and psychiatric disorders such as schizophrenia, anxiety, and depression. In particular, THC, the main psychoactive component of marijuana, through overstimulation of CB1 receptor, impacts the endocannabinoid system, leading to the pathological phenotypes. Moreover, several studies have reported that THC exposure during adolescence induces morphological abnormalities in hippocampus and alteration in its glutamatergic signaling. On the other hand, clinical and preclinical evidence have reported a functional dissociation between anterior and posterior hippocampus, identified as ventral and dorsal in rodents. Although the hippocampus has been mainly related to memory, these studies pointed out a potential role of the ventral hippocampus in emotional processes and anxiety, while the dorsal hippocampus was mainly related to cognitive function and memory. Consider that our hypothesis was that THC exposure during adolescence might induce different long-lasting effects in the ventral and dorsal portion of the hippocampus. To this aim, we use a neurodevelopmental rodent model of THC exposure during adolescence. Male rats were treated with increasing doses of THC between postnatal day 35 to 45, comparable with the human adolescents. After 30 days, rats underwent a battery of behavioral tasks to assess anxiety and memory, a detailed molecular examination, and an analysis of the electrical activity in dorsal and ventral hippocampus. Our results revealed the adolescent THC exposure inducing long-lasting anxiety as measured from the longer latency to re-emerge from the dark in the LiDAR box, a task based on the natural aversion of rats for the bright environment. Moreover, when the rats were placed in an open field arena, they did not show any difference between vehicle and THC in the motility. However, the THC did significantly less entries and less reading in the center of the arena. This effect is called tigmotaxis and is based on the preference of rats to stay safe close to the walls of the arena. We next evaluated the effect of THC exposure on memory impairment. We exposed the rat to two identical objects, and after 1 hour or 5 hours, one object was moving at a different location. The THC rats were not able to identify the new location after 5 hours, while they did not show any difference after 1 hour. We next evaluated the ability of the rats to associate the object with the context. Rats encountered two identical objects in the context A and another two objects in the context B. After 3 hours, one object was moving in a different context. As you can see from the graph, the TSC were not able to identify this mismatch between the object and the context. We next evaluated the effect of THC exposure during adolescence at the molecular level. Taking advantage of an innovative technique called MALDMS, we quantify GABA, glutamate, and dopamine in dorsal and ventral hippocampus. Dopamine was decreased in both areas, while the GABA was decreased only in the dorsal hippocampus, and no difference was observed in the glutamate in both areas. On the other hand, protein analysis revealed an interesting opposite trend between dorsal and ventral hippocampus in glutamatergic signaling. The NMDA2B receptor were significantly decreased in dorsal hippocampus while it was decreased in ventral hippocampus. Accordingly, mGlu2/3 was significantly increased in the ventral hippocampus. No difference were found in GABA and dopamine receptors in both areas. Consider this imbalance in glutamatergic signaling between the dorsal and ventral hippocampus, we next evaluated the electrical activity of glutamatergic neurons. Accordingly with the molecular data, we found a significant decrease in the electrical activity of the glutamatergic cells in dorsal hippocampus following THC exposure, while no difference were found in the ventral hippocampus. Then we evaluated the local field potential, which is a measure of the brain activity resulting from the excitatory and inhibitory inputs reaching our area of interest. Also in this case, we found an opposite trend in beta waves as they were increased in the dorsal hippocampus and decreased in the ventral hippocampus. Moreover, the theta wave was significantly increased in the ventral hippocampus. Our results provide evidence that THC exposure during adolescence impacts different ventral and dorsal hippocampus function, which is connectivity might lead to cognitive and affective pathological outcomes of cannabis consumption. I would like to thank the people mentioned here which contributed to this project and the funding agencies that are actually supporting our study. Please reach out if you have any questions or comments, and thank you for your attention.